Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'll show you how you can create a hand-cut image effect in Photoshop. Before we get started with this tutorial, let's have a look and see what it is that we're aiming for. I'm going to show you the original image I'm going to be starting with here. And what we're going to do is isolate the image on its layer. We're going to add a sort of white border around it, so it could be used in various collage projects. And what I'm going to do here is actually show you it on a background here. So I've got it dragged into a collage project. And so we're going to see how we can create this sort of white edged look very easily for our images. So first of all, let's tuck this one away. I'm just going to delete those layers before we start, and let's just tuck that away, and let's go back and get our bird image. Now, the first thing that I would do with this particular image is to convert the background layer into a regular layer. So I'm just going to get everything back to what it was. And if this layer here that we're seeing in front of us were the background layer, I would just double click it to convert it into a regular layer. The next thing I'm going to do is to isolate this bird and the pieces that I want. Now, I'm using the quick select tool because it's quite a good tool for this and it's going to make the job go pretty quickly. So I'm just selecting over the areas of the bird that I want, and if the selection goes too far, then like it just did there, I'm just going to hold the Alt key as I drag over the area that I want to remove from the selection. So I can select over the pieces if I want to add a bit to it. I'm just checking to make sure the bird looks pretty good, but this could be edited later on. This effect is actually editable. So if you find that there's a chunk of the bird missing or there's a chunk of the background in it that you don't want to include, you can easily get rid of that later on. So I'm just making a reasonable selection here, and then I'm going to add a layer mask to this layer. So I'm just going to click here on the Add Layer Mask icon, and that isolates the bird from its background. And you could brush this layer with black or white paint to make the edges smoother or whatever you want to do, or you could add more of the bird or subtract it by just painting on this mask. But for now, we're going to assume that the mask is just fine. I'm going to add a new layer by clicking the Add New Layer icon here, and I just want to fill it with this blue color. So with the blue color as the foreground color, I'm going to press Alt Backspace Option Delete. You can see I could do a bit of tidying up in here. I'm going to leave you to do that yourself. With this particular layer selected, I'm now going to add a stroke to it. So I'm going to click the Add Layer Style, I'm going to click Stroke. The color stroke I want is white, or whatever you were opting as your sort of paper color, because we want the idea that this bird has been cut out of a piece of paper. So you could use an off-white if you wanted to. I'm just using plain white. I'm going to increase the size of this so it looks as if there's a border edge around the bird, and you can make that size whatever you want. It needs to be on the outside. If you put it on the inside, you're just shrinking your bird down and you're losing detail here. Doesn't want to be in the center either, you'll have the same problem. It must be on the outside. So having done that, I'm just going to click OK. So essentially that's my cutout bird, and I could just drag and drop him into a collage if I wanted to, but I want to show you quickly how to do that tape effect. I've got this installed as a brush, and all I did was look for tape as a brush, and there are a lot of free commercial brushes that you can use. So here's my tape brush. I'm just going to use this one. I'm going to make sure that I'm using red because I kind of like using red tape, and I'm going to do it on a brand new layer. So I'm going to size my brush down using the square bracket key and just press 3 or 4 times to get that tape effect. Now, if I want to use the same piece of tape over and over again, I've got this brush panel open, so I can now rotate the brush so that the tape is where I want it to be. If I just open up the spacing, we'll be able to see what angle it's going out at, and that will allow me to then stick it onto the bird in the angle that I want it to appear at. And I could obviously, of course, use a different piece of tape if I wanted to, but I'm just doing this very simply and very quickly. So now that we've got our tape, let's go back and get our background. This is the striped background that I created. and we're going to our bird image. I'm going to take the tape layer and the bird layer and just drag and drop them together into my collage. And now I can move it using the move tool, size it if I want to, and it's now in position on the collage. So that's how you create a sort of cut out, taped on effect in Photoshop very easily using a stroke. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. Look out for more of my tutorials on this YouTube channel. Please consider subscribing to my channel and visit my website at projectwoman.com for more tips, tricks, and tutorials on Photoshop, Lightroom, Illustrator, and a whole lot more.